the distillery, they gave Bundaberg something much more than a rum.
This is a place, this is a community. It's 125 years old. It's been through all the major milestones that Australia has as well. And it's been able to grow up with Australia.
It's a big part of the community here, Bundy Rum. It's been here for a long time. This probably sounds a bit delayed
in a few short years.
Ambitious plans have been made to celebrate the milestone.
This is a once-in-a-lifetime project, something that I've been really proud to work on. It's been a really complex project.
By aiming to create the most exceptional rum to date, they want to bring together the past, the present, and the future. The Australian state of Queensland is home to Bundaberg, a town surrounded by sugarcane fields and cut through by the Gurnett River. Sitting side by side with the local sugar mill, the Bundaberg Distilling Company is synonymous in Australia with rum. It's a major local employer, a large tourist attraction, and has made this Queensland town famous throughout Australia.
Bundaberg rum.
Bundaberg rum.
Because we need to leave a few things in there. So worst case, today the whole factory could blow up. We don't want that to happen. So we're going to leave lighters and matches in the locker. We also can't take out anything with a battery that could malfunction and create a spark. So if you've got mobile phones, cameras, MP3 players, electronic car keys, even watches, they'll all have to go. That sugar mill across the road, you guys would have seen that when you drove in today. It's called the Milliken Sugar Mill. They started up in 1882, crushing sugar cane and getting molasses as their byproduct. And with the molasses, they used to store it in little barrels. Eventually, they ran out of storage space, and they needed to do something with that molasses. So they came up with the best idea, I reckon. They turned it all into rum. 127 years later, we're still producing our rum to the exact same recipe as the day we started. So I'm going to teach you guys two words to use on the tour. I'm going to use them as well. And they're actually to pay a bit of homage to those millers from back in the day. So the first word, if you're excited, if you're having a good time, if you like one of my jokes, or if you like a taste test, you need to yell out, huzzah!
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 And the fist pump is optional. Now the second word is the opposite. If you don't like a joke, if you don't like a taste test, if you think I'm pulling your leg, or you don't like a smell, you need to yell, poppycock.
Poppycock.
You guys seem real excited about these words.